In this tutorial, we'll learn how to use column widget inside a container, inside scaffold, and within column widget, we'll also see how to use container and different kind of other widgets, okay? Well, now here, I'll remove everything. Here, I have the scaffold. I'll remove this. And here, this file name is column row container, which is coming from main.dart. It's inside material app. So basically saying here is pretty much everything is empty. Okay, now first here I'll put a column widget and we'll see. Okay, I'll put a row widget, right? Okay, and here I'll have children. We know that row widget takes children, and within it I'll have a text and I'll say hi there, and then I'll put a style over here so that we know the text is visible and big enough. So you do text style. Here I would do, say, font size, say 40, and I would do color, so we do colors.white. Okay, now let's save it and see. So here it is, okay? Now, row widget has its basic properties. Well, so first thing we have to understand, row widget is basically made for horizontal direction like this, okay? Horizontal direction. All right, it's being cranky, so let's add a modifier and hopefully it'll solve the problem. Okay, good. So now here, row widget has been basically made for horizontal direction, but of course you can work with this on vertical direction. By the way, so this is horizontal direction, this is vertical direction. Now row widget has its own default properties. The first default properties is it's put itself, whatever the children you put inside row widget, it puts those children or child at the beginning of main axis. Okay, so what is the main axis? Well, for row widget, the main axis is a horizontal widget, a horizontal line, I would say. And for row widget, cross axis is this vertical line over here, okay? So that's one thing we have to remember. One second, let me repeat. For row widget, main axis is this horizontal axis, and cross axis is this vertical axis, okay? All right, so another thing is that it put itself, the children, it puts the children at the beginning of row widget, okay? Or at the beginning of this horizontal axis. And at the same time, it puts in the vertical axis or cross axis at the center. So if you hover over on it, you'll see this. Main axis at the start. So this is the start. And it says that cross axis at the center. So this is the cross axis and this is the center, okay? All right. Now, of course, with this, what we could do, we could change a little bit over here. Now here, this is the main axis, right? Or the horizontal axis. Here, we can change the default settings of main axis. Here, we could do main axis dot center. So it'll put itself in the center, okay? All right. And you can play with other properties like end, okay? So it'll put it at the end of this main axis or the horizontal axis. Do remember row widget and horizontal axis, they're aligned together and that's why they are made for primarily, okay? Of course, you can at the same time play with the cross axis alignment over here. So we do cross axis alignment. Here we do say start, okay? So this is the cross axis alignment, so it'll put it at the beginning. Okay, so it goes there. All right. Of course, we can also put it at the end. Okay. So it goes at the end, right? All right. Now, once again, let me comment them out. So it'll fall back to the default property. So the default property of row widget is that putting its children at the beginning of horizontal axis and at the center of vertical axis. That's how it works, okay? And the same is true for column, okay? All right. So for column, the main axis is this vertical axis, and horizontal axis, this becomes the secondary axis, okay? Once again, or the cross axis, okay? So for column, the main axis is the vertical axis, and this horizontal axis become the cross axis, okay? Well, now it's the same as a row, so it puts at the beginning of its main axis. What is the main axis? The vertical axis is the main axis. So it puts its children at the beginning, as you can see, and at the center of its cross axis alignment. So horizontal axis is the cross axis alignment, okay? All right, now here I made a little note for you. So it says that column or row puts the children at the start of its main axis. So this is column, so puts the children, this is children, at the start of its main axis. So this is the main axis and this is at the beginning, okay? All right, so let's do it row. So for row, the main axis is this horizontal axis and at the beginning, okay? And it says to center them on the cross axis. So for row, the vertical axis is the cross axis and it's in the center. As you can see, it's vertically centered. All right, so these are the default property of row and column, okay? Well, if you ever forget it, you can hover over on them and you will see this, all right? Now, a lot of time we use this column widget a lot, okay? So we'll go back to that very soon. But now, so we know the default axis, default properties. Now, what happens if I put it around a scaffold widget? Okay, so wrap the row or column inside a scaffold widget, and of course we need to use the body property. All right, now let's see what happens. Okay, now it looks invisible, but we'll use background color. We'll do colors.blue. Okay, all right, so you see it's a bit different now, and let's, instead of row, let's use column and see what happens. So just now we saw, okay, once again, let me copy this, cut it and replace, put it there. So here, as you see that now I go back to the original property, but as soon as I put it inside scaffold, so I can do Control Z to go back to scaffold like this, okay? Now you see it's not in the center of cross axis anymore. What does it mean? It means that when you put column inside scaffold directly, column loses its one of the properties. Well, we learned that column has two interesting property here. So it says the main axis is at the start. Well, here its main axis is still at the start, but here it says that cross axis at the center, but it's not at the center anymore. So what we learned is that if you put column inside scaffold, it loses its one of the primary properties, which means that it doesn't really put its children or child at the middle of cross axis, okay? The same goes for row, okay? So now if you wrap it around row, of course, no change here, all right? Even if you try to restart it, you will see that it's still there. So row also loses its one of the basic properties, because we know that row puts at the beginning of horizontal axis. Well, this is horizontal axis at the beginning and vertically center at the cross axis. So this is cross axis, but it's not vertically centered. It should be here, but it's not, right? So this is very important lesson that we should know. So if you have column and row inside the scaffold, it will lose one of the properties, okay? You should know that. Now, how to take care of this problem, okay? So in general, if you want to be able to use all the properties of column and row, you should wrap them around a widget that has certain width and height, all right? So in this case, with the column, first we'll wrap it around a container widget, okay? All right. Well, with the default container widget, of course, there is no width and height. So here, now column, in our case, the column is working properly, right? How we can say that? Let's see. So for the column, we are in column right now, and this is the main axis, And so if we uncomment this one, we'll see it's still working, okay? Even if you don't have a column within scaffold, the main axis property, it's always work, okay? We can put it at the center. Yeah, it's still there. And the same truth for row. Main axis always there. Doesn't matter if you put in this column, in the container, or without them, okay? All right. So I'll use column for now here. So we are still at the center. But we saw earlier that if we didn't have scaffold or column, or container, using this property, we can put them in the center. Okay, but it doesn't work now, because once you put anything inside this scaffold or container which doesn't have any exact width and height, it loses one of the properties. Once again, let me take this out. Let me put it here over here. Okay, let's see. So we'll say it's at the center over here. Okay, I can do center, okay. All right. So it's still center. But as soon as I do Control Z, I'll go back to the scaffold. We'll see that it lost its property. Okay, let's save it. Yes, just like that, okay? So cross-axis property doesn't work of column or row inside scaffold. You have to know that, all right? And to work with that, now you have to give it certain width and height. Now here we saw that for column, yeah, the vertical axis over here, this always works because, the horizontal main axis. So what is the main axis? The main axis is this column over here. So it's center, right? So now we have problem with this cross-axis alignment, which is this horizontal axis. Now this has to do with width. So we can give it width, right? Let's give it width over here. So let's give it width, say 200. And now let's see what happens. So now it's trying to go back to its original property, column's original property, putting things in the center of horizontal axis. So this is our horizontal axis. So let's see, we can give it a color, okay? Colors.red. So now our container has a certain color, all right? So it's trying to get back its original property. So column's original property is this one, we learned it. Okay, center on the cross axis. So this is the cross axis for center, and trying to put it. Now, it works, right? So now it's a 300. Now I can do here double dot max infinite. Okay, so now it's working. So if we have a column and column is inside scaffold or container, your container should have width or height. Of course, for column, you always need width to be able to center things horizontally inside scaffold. Remember, so this is basically inside scaffold. If you don't have scaffold, we just learned that column keeps its original properties and no problem. But within scaffold, column loses its properties, especially it loses its horizontal axis property. In that case, you have to give it value horizontally, okay? The same is true for row axis or row widget, okay? So that's how it works. So hopefully you learned something. Thank you.